What is the phrase "day I forgot" mean to you?
The day I forgot is really about a feeling, man. A feeling you get when you look to the west.
When you hang out with old friends and you start telling stories about things that you did years ago that you totally forgot about, and you're like, oh my god, you know, you get all excited. You get that feeling. I had been hanging out with a lot of old friends too while I was making this record. This record is kind of an extension of Music for the Morning After. It's Music for the Morning After the Day I Forgot.
You're on.
Hey friends, we're down at Mesmer Studios, Culver City, California. Come check out what we do here. It's a place where we make noise. This is Walt Vincent.
How's it going?
He's on the phone.
I'm on the phone.
The album is The Day I Forgot. I think. That's it.
Here's where we drum. We like to put microphones in front of us. And we go. Check this out. This is our bag of percussion instruments. And these things are called gotos, and they're goat toes. But they're actually made out of goat toes.
Yeah.
And they're all over the record. They like do little like... They're kind of gross, actually. Well, let's go into the main studio, shall we? These are our guitars lined up. This is my number one favorite. This is my Epiphone John Lennon Casino model. It still has blood on it from Glastonbury. This is Brad Wood at the helm, doing interesting things.
I've seen absolutely no growth between this record and that, and the first. If nothing else, major step back. Mentally, he's really fallen off. And I have to say, you know, maturity-wise, he's really taken a huge step backwards also. So it's a real disappointment.
What would you credit that to?
Did you get that?
And we could take you back here to the courtyard where there's a couple of crazy dogs. We might be able to stir them up. Watch this.
Lucy!
Oh, there's Lucy.
Don't get me, boy. Get the dog.
Hello, Lucy.
This is Lucy.
The Day I Forgot.
I'm working on the record for so far about a month and a week right now, and we're almost done with it. The process was pretty much the same. I think we were building on everything that we learned making the last record. That's why it was good to work for me. It was fun to work with Walt and Brad again. We learned so much making the last one that for me it just didn't make sense to not work with them again.
I always want to work with artists more than once, you know, because it's like putting on your favorite old shirt, and there isn't that awkward getting to know you phase. There's things that have changed, but there's a lot that stays the same.
I think this record's a little more upbeat than Music for the Morning After. I think it's going to be a little bit more of a feel-good record.
You know, I don't think of it in terms of a particular album per se. Albums just happen, but I think of it more as chowder. Just a big bowl of Pete Yorn music chowder.
Oh, I see. Single should be the song that really kind of just sums up the place I was emotionally when I made the record and things that I was thinking about. As of right now, that would probably be a song called Come Back Home, which I remember writing on the road when touring came to an end, and you know what it would be like to kind of readjust back into some sort of normal lifestyle of, you know, sleeping in your bed every night and you know, reflecting on the whole crazy year and a half. That song is still really relevant to me. But it's, you know, that's what it means to me. If you hear the song and I tell you what it's about, it's really universal. You know, you could
I'm sure you could plug it into your own life like a horoscope. Come back home for another year. I always thought that you could. The last day of recording at Bixie. That would be December. What? What's today? December 18th, 2002. We'll be doing finishing touches on Day I Forgot, the second heavy from Pete Yorn and Company. I feel very good about the work we've done. It's been a very fun process.
You guys making my record?
I don't do the plunger.
Will you guys finish my record, please? Keep rubbing.
A few weeks ago, I was a little burnt. I was ready to just, you know. And we have so many songs, you know, so many finished songs. But I feel good now. I feel like we have so much to choose from, so much stuff. It'll be interesting to see how the record shapes up. It'll be like kind of a jigsaw puzzle. It was good in the beginning. I still get butterflies before I go back out on stage. I'll still be, you know, standing on the side of the stage, ready to go on, and be like, you know, ready to throw up. It says it's still important to me. I guess if I didn't care, you know, then maybe I wouldn't get butterflies and I wouldn't feel that nervous energy before I go play. But I do care. Because I want it to be great every time, you know. It's just about a feeling. Music to me is about a feeling. When you think of the songs that you loved when you were growing up, or songs that you love right now, if you break it down, what is it that you really love about it? I don't know. For me, it's just, it makes me feel a certain way. It makes me feel cool. It makes me want to go drink beer in the woods. It makes me want to go, you know, call some girl up. It makes me want to go, you know, run, you know, down my street for 3 hours. Whatever it is, it makes you feel a certain way, and you take that with you and you translate that into your own life. And that's what this next record is all about, The Day I Forgot, and that's what the title means. It's just, it's a feeling.